Farmer Maggot's wagon carried us safely away from his farm and into the borders of Buckland. But the Black Rider was still thundering along the East Road. We decided to go south and cut through the Old Forest. Merry had been in the Old Forest and knew a little of its ways. It's a dark, mysterious place, but not as dangerous as a Black Rider. Hello? Merry? Pippin? Sam? Where are you?
Oi! Frodo!
We're over here.
And lost by the looks of it. These trees have a mind of their own.
Stay where you are. I'll find you. This forest, it's as if it had a mind of its own.
We're over here!
Thank you.
Frodo!
Help! never thought potatoes could smell so good.
A good meal will definitely ease my mind about this place.
But where is this place?
Very close to the Withywindle Valley. But we shouldn't get any closer.
Why not?
The Withywindle Valley is said to be the strangest part of the whole forest. The center from which all the strangeness comes, as it were.
Can you lead us around the valley, Merry?
I thought I could, but the way these trees shift about, I don't know. It's like they're leading us there.
Merry thought he knew his way around this forest, but how can anyone find their way when the forest won't stand still?
Do you know one of those trees stuck a branch out at me? Nearly tripped me, it did.
I'm sorry I led us into such a dangerous place, but at least we've shaken off that black rider. Can't go on. Oh, must have nap.
It's cool under the willows. Less flies.
I don't like this tree. I don't trust it. Hear it singing about sleep? That's not right. It's not right at all.
We can't sleep yet. We must get clear of this place.
Stop! Stop it! You'll squeeze me in two if you don't stop! Don't stop.
Thank you.
it! He'll squeeze me in two if you don't stop! Stop. Don't stop.
steady there, little fellows. Where be you a-going to, eh? Puffing like a bellows? What's the matter, then? Come now, tell me what's your trouble.
My friends are caught in that willow tree.
Old Man Willow? I know the rhyme for him. I'll chant his marrow cold if he don't behave himself. You let them out again, Old Man Willow. You should not be waking. Eat earth, drink water, go to sleep. Bombadil is talking.
Thank you. Yes, thank you.
Very much.
Well, my little fellows, you shall come to the house of Tom Bombadil.
Where?
Time enough for questions around the supper table. Come now and help Tom find lilies for fair Lady Goldberry. After that, we shall sit down to a table laden with cream, honeycomb, and white bread and butter.
What are we waiting for? The sooner we find lilies, the sooner we can eat.
for the fair river daughter. Come, let us go to meet her.
Come, dear folk, laugh and be merry. I am Goldberry, daughter of the river.
Here's my Goldberry.
You are still afraid, perhaps, of mist and tree shadows. Fear nothing, for tonight you are under the roof of Tom Bombadil.
Who are you?
Eh, what? Don't you know my name? It's the only answer. For who are you without your name? But you are young and I am old. Eldest, that's what I am.
Tom was here before the river and the trees. Tom remembers the first raindrop, the first big people, and the first little people. He was here before kings and Barrow-wights, before the elves passed westward, and before the seas were bent, before the Dark Lord came from outside.
His precious ring has no power over Tom Bombadil. And now, merry friends, it is time for our supper.
We ate our first good meal in a long time, singing songs and telling tales until late in the night. We slept peacefully and were refreshed enough to continue our journey.
Keep to the green grass as you go, lads. Don't go meddling with old stone or prying into the houses of old dead Barrow-wights. Here's a song to sing should you fall into any danger. Oh, Tom Bombadil, Tom Bombadil, oh, by water, wood and hill, by the reed and willow, by fire, sun and moon. Hearken now and hear us. Come, Tom Bombadil, for our need is near us.
Thank you, Tom Bombadil.
Speed now, fair guests. North with the wind in the left eye and a blessing on your footsteps. Make haste while the sun shines. Farewell, friends. It was a merry meeting.
Keep to the green grass as you go, lads. Don't go meddling with old stone or prying into the houses of old dead Barrow-wights.
Farewell, friends. It was a merry meeting.
the Barrow-downs. Even Tom is cautious about this place.
We're not far from the main road by my reckoning.
Splendid. If we keep this pace, we'll leave the Barrow-downs by sunset tomorrow.
Not soon enough for my liking. I don't trust what's hiding in the fog on the Barrow-downs.
You don't believe stories about old dead Barrow-wights?
Not until today, but Tom said otherwise.
Tom is the only one not affected by the ring. I wonder why.
He was here before the Dark Lord came from outside. Outside what, I wonder?
And whatever did he mean by eldest?
And why didn't he serve bacon, or cutlets, or sausages?
I don't like spending the night among these burial stones. They look like giant teeth coming up from the ground.
If half the stories I've heard about the Barrow-downs are true, we'll need to keep a careful watch.
Enough storytelling. Let's get to sleep. Sam? Merry? Pippin? Where are you? Where could they be? Sam? Merry? Anyone? Where are you? The fog here is quite thick indeed.
Ah!
Sam. Merry, wake up, all of you. I've got to set them free. Get them out of here. It'll take a special weapon to stop this thing. If anything can. Listen to Tom. Wait. Perhaps Tom is near. Ho, Tom Bombadil, Tom Bombadil, oh. By water, wood, and hill, by the reed and the willow, by fire, sun, and moon. Hearken now and hear us. Come, Tom Bombadil, for our need is near us.
Well, little friends, old Tom has answered your call. Get out, old white, vanish in the sunlight, shrivel like the cold mist till the world is mended. Out into the barren lands, far beyond the mountains, come never here again. Leave your barrow empty, lost and forgotten, be darker than the darkness, where gates stand forever shut till the world is mended.
Thank you. Thank you, Tom.
The spell on this barrow lies broken, and no wight shall ever come back to it. I've scattered the barrow's treasures. They're free to all finders. Old Tom has taken a pretty toy for his lady, and here are some fine blades for young hobbits who go walking into dark and danger.
It's perfectly clean, untouched by time.
Yes, thank you again.
They were forged long ago by the men of Westerness across the sea in ancient Numenor. They cast spells on their blades for the bane of the Dark Lord. Their kings of Numenor are forgotten now, but their sons wander in loneliness, guarding simple folk from wicked things.
I wonder if this blade can hurt one of the Black Riders.
Old Tom shall see you safe over the borders of his land. From there you should travel to Bree, a fair village. Stay the night at the Prancing Pony Inn.
Fair advice. Lead the way.
Ready to follow Tom, then?
Indeed. The further we are from the barrows, the better.
Let us speed on our way.
We left the cold stone fields of the Barrow-downs and arrived at the hillside village of Bree, home to both hobbits and big folk. We said goodbye to Tom and entered Bree, seeking a warm fire and a door between us and the night. At last, we found a cheerful inn with the sign of the Prancing Pony.